Good morning students, today we are going to see another concept that is scattering of light and Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect you have already studied in chemistry, I think in 9th standard chemistry you have this topic, Tyndall effect. So in that you are going to study the scattering of light. So what is the scattering of light? Now as you have studied in white light, if you use a prism or if any glass material which can disperse the light into 7 colors, so in this color you will see 7 different colors, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, that is Webb or pattern. Okay, Webb, Webb or pattern you can see. Okay, and the wavelength of these colors, as in that time also I have explained you that Webb or in this violet, blue, green, all these are the shorter, all these have short wavelengths. Okay, and the this yellow, orange, red, these have a larger wavelength. Okay, so in this condition, if you will see in the 7 colors, these are having shorter wavelength and large wavelengths. So because of this, what happens in scattering? So what is this phenomena of scattering? It is that when a light, as you know, sun is the source of light, sun emits the light, and if while coming into the atmosphere there are many dust particles. You can see in our atmosphere there are many tiny particles, air molecules, dust particles, many small particles are there. So while entering into our earth, this sunlight strikes with this small tiny particles. Okay, so this sunlight when strike to the particles, what happens? There is a scattering. The light scatters. So how it scatters? Now as it is a white light, when it scatters or when it hits with the tiny particle, scattering occurs. Which light scatters the most when it strikes? It is the blue color lights. Okay, blue color light scatters the most. So that's why you can see the sky is blue. This concept also you are going to study, why sky is blue. This you have in this lesson. So because of this, when the sunlight falls on the earth, that time it strikes small particles which scatters the light, and this scattering, so that's why it scatters the blue color light. And now you will think, why everything, all things are not looking blue? Because when the sunlight falls towards the earth, 90% light falls as it is. So that's why you can see the sunlight's its own color. But 10% of light, what happens? It strikes the small particles, dust particles, and it scatters and it emits the blue color light. Because all these blue shades you can see, it has a shorter wavelength. That's why what happens here, scattering occurs. So here you can see the phenomena of change in direction of light on striking on a very small sized particles like atom, dust particle, etc. The particle, very small particle means the particle should be 1 nanometer small. 1 nanometer means 10⁻⁹ meter. This much small particle, if there is in the atmosphere, so what happened? This light falls on it and it changes. Now you know, if any sunlight is falling on it, when it strikes something, what happens? It will change its path, and also what happens? It scatters. Okay, and which light scatters from that? Blue light scatters over here because it has shorter wavelength. So what is the reason behind this? The reason behind the scattering of light is the composition of size of the particle and wavelength. Just now I have explained you why scattering occurs. Two conditions are there. First, the size of the particle should be very small, and second condition is the wavelength of the light. Now you can see in symbol I have written x is very smaller than wavelength of light. So here x symbol is for the size of the particle and lambda is wavelength of the light. Very simple condition is x very smaller than lambda. X is the size of the particle, means size of the particle should be very small, and lambda is the wavelength. Okay, as compared to the lambda. So this was the scattering of light. Okay, how this occurs, that it is explained by the Tyndall effect. In chemistry, what you have studied? You have studied that if you are taking any solution in the glass, if you are taking a solution, colloidal solution, if you will take, colloidal solution means what? It can suspend the particle into it. Okay, if the particles are suspended into the liquid or that solution, and if you enter, if you pass the light into such particles, what happens? The light strike with the particles and it gets scattered. This you have studied. So what is this? Scattering of light by particles in its path. In that path, what particles are coming? When the light hits the particles, what happens? It gets scatters. So, and this effect, it is called as Tyndall effect. When white light is passed through a liquid colloidal solution having particles suspended in it, then the blue color scatters more. If you see, same, when the particles are there, okay, when the light enters into the glass of the colloidal solution and when it hits the particles in it, what happened? There is scattering take place. And which light scatters the most, blue or red? Yes, blue light scatters the more because blue have shorter wavelength. That's why you can see the blue light scatters the most because of shorter wavelength as compared to the red, because red has very high wavelength, larger wavelength it has. Okay. Now we are going to study two important questions and concept of the lesson, and this is the last topic of our lesson, that is why the sky is blue. And second, you are going to study color of sun at sunrise and sunset, means why it appears reddish color at sunrise and at sunset. These are the two questions you are going to study, and it is also concept you are going to study now. Now see, very simple question. When you go out of your house at morning, you can see at morning means at 10 o'clock, 10, 11, okay, 9 to 10, 11. This time if you will see what happened, this sun is the sun appears blue in color. Why you can see the sun blue in color? As there are 7 colors in the white light, why only blue color you can see? Okay, as you have studied the scattering of light, in that you have studied how much small particle is there in the atmosphere, and when the light strikes to it, what happens? It will scatter blue color. Same reason over here. If you will see, the molecule of air and other fine particles in the atmosphere have smaller size than wavelength, okay, of visible light. So the same reason is here. Because of the scattering, out of 100% of sunlight, 90% comes as it is towards the earth, and 10% what happens? If you see a 10% of light, what happens? It will scatter because of the dust particle. It will fall on the dust particles, small, very fine. How much small dust particles it can scatter the light? Okay, when it falls on that particle, what happens? It splits, scatters the light, and the shorter wavelength, that is blue color, it is spread everywhere. Okay, it scatters everywhere. So that's why you can see the sky blue. If you will think, just think that if there will be no atmosphere, then what would happen? If no atmosphere is there, then what happens? There is no scattering of light, and what will happen? There will be no color. You can see no scattering, no atmosphere. There will be no scattering. And same, I can tell you about the universe. If you will see, what is there any blue color in the universe? No, it is dark color, black color, because there is no scattering takes place. That's why there is no any blue color, no any color. That's why our universe, if you will see out space, looks black color. Okay, because there is no atmosphere, so no scattering. Same, if there will be no atmosphere on the earth, what happens? There will be no scattering, and you cannot see the blue color of the sky. Now one more question arises: why clouds are white in color? Okay, now everything is blue, sky is blue, why clouds are white in color? It is because, as I have told you, that sun emits all its light, only 90% of light as it is, it reflects, and 10% into blue color. So this 90% of light also comes for the cloud, means as it is, means whatever the sunlight is emitting, directly it falls on the clouds, and you can see the clouds white in color. Okay, so now see, this is the process why sky look blue. I have written here, when the light travels into the atmosphere, then there are fine particles in the air, and this scatters the blue color more. okay, more strongly it scatters the blue color and then means stronger than the red color. So what happened, this scattered blue color light enters into our eyes and we can see the sky blue. Okay, understood. Now we'll go for the second concept, color of sun at sunrise and sunset. Why at sunset and at sunrise you can see reddish color, okay, that you will see. See the figure over here, and this is I have drawn the layer, atmospheric layer. Okay, now see, this is the condition, this is the condition near horizon, this is the condition above our head. As you know, sun rises, then it comes above our head at noon, and then what happens again, it sunsets. So this condition I have drawn. From here sun is rising, it is at noon and it is our overhead, and afterwards it will set down. Okay, at this condition here also we can draw sunset. Okay, these are the three conditions. At this, when the sun rises, which color you will see? You will see reddish color. Why reddish color? Because sun is at the horizon. When the sun is at the horizon, that time what happens? What happens at the time of horizon? Here, observer can see red color, because if you will see the distance from here till here, means at the horizon, the distance is very big as compared to our overhead. Overhead means the distance is less. If you will see this shape here, that this distance at near the horizon, the distance is less, distance is larger, and above our head, if you will see, the distance is less. So because of this, what happens, you can see the near horizon lights. When the sun is here, light have to pass through the thick atmosphere or thick layer of air, if you will see, and it has also yet have to travel a larger distance in the earth's atmosphere before reaching our eye. Okay, if you will see, here is the observer. If the observer is here, so what happens to that observer, the light, here it is the observer, the light which falls on the observer's eye, it has to travel a larger distance, and it also have to travel the thick layer of air. And because of this, what happens? Because of means this distance, you can see when it is above our head, the distance is very less. Okay, and at noon timing, so what happens, light have to travel relatively shorter distance as compared to the distance at the horizon. And because of this, what happened, blue and violet colors are scattered in small amount. Okay, it is scattered in small amount, and when here when it has to travel a larger distance, that time what happened, there is mostly all the blue color light has scattered away. Okay, it has scattered away blue color light. If the all blue color light is scattered, which light is remaining over there? Reddish color, which has the larger wavelength light. And the larger wavelength light, what happens, it scatters at the horizon, both sides. Okay, and because the blue color light has already scattered, so remaining red color light you can see at the horizon. And as it moves forward, as it goes, okay, up, that time what happens, here the distance will start reducing. As the distance will start reducing, what happens, this reddish color, it as you know, in Webjar, what happens, from blue it shifted from red, if you will see oppositely. So what happens, from red it will shift to the orange color, and from the orange it will shift yellow, and you can see the color of the sunlight directly at the noon. Okay, so this is how, as it again you can see, as it, at the sunset, when it is moving downwards again to the sunset, again you can see the color changes. You can see from yellowish it becomes to orange, then to reddish color at the time of sunset, because again here it is the at horizon. At the horizon, what happens again? So this distance, if you will see, it is light have to travel a longer distance. At it again, it has to travel through a thick layer of air. And because of this larger distance, what happened, again you can see the red color, because mostly during the daytime the sun has scattered all its blue color light, and remaining red color light again you can see at the horizon. Okay, understood. It's a very simple topic, and because of this, what happened at horizon, blue color scatters and remaining red color scatters at sunlight. Okay, at the sunrise and sunset. So as we have completed this lesson, you have to complete now the intake, all intake questions as well as exercise you will complete and you will send to me. Okay, and the question number from 8 to 13, this question numbers are very important for your exam. Okay, main part, as I have explained you, human eye and colorful human eye, its working and structure of eye. This is it is also very important. Between part is deleted, and these questions, what you have studied, all these the question exercise question number 8 to 13, they are very important questions of this lesson. Okay, so prepare it properly, solve the exercise and intake question, as well as worksheet is also given to you. Okay, solve that worksheet and you will send to me. Thank you.